Almost feel almost something feel coming, something on, coming here. On
the Nava do
When Independence Day was offered to me, I was thrilled to do it just because it was reminiscent of all the big sci-fi films that I loved as a kid. We decided to use Alias Wavefront as a primary software package for the computer graphics unit. The F-18s were initially planned to be motion control model miniatures in the foreground and CG in the background. We did some tests, they turned out wonderfully. Our guys did a great job of making them photorealistic. So there are a lot of shots where people think that the foreground elements are model miniatures, but they're not, they're CG.
The movie itself involved a broad spectrum of effects, and in the case of particles, we did everything from this destruction beam, which is very whimsical and magical and yet powerful. And then on the other spectrum, we had particles doing smoke trails from missiles being fired by F-18s.
One of the things that we were really able to do was give them the ability to change things after they were shot. Suppose they shot something, it was planned a particular way in motion control, and they decided after cutting it together with other things that, you know, boy, it would be nice if the planes moved in a different direction.
Mark!
When we went from about 77 CG shots to over 200, 250 CG shots, that was when we really needed that flexibility.
I went through that experience of the hurricane in Niki and Kauai, actually, during the filming of Jurassic Park, and I thought it was very fascinating. As much as it is scary, it's also very fascinating to experience that brute force of nature.
Come on, come on!
Holding that. Holding that. The challenge of Twister was certainly creating the tornadoes. It was clear to us from the beginning that we would have to use technology, especially software technology, that we did not have available at that point in time when we started to look at the project, and that we would have to figure out how to really manipulate basically large number of particles.
Alias Wavefront fit in the program because we were looking for a software where we could simulate millions of particles to get the dynamics we needed in what happens in a tornado. And we had used the software before on the mask.
Smoking!
The particle system allowed us to easily go in and kind of tailor it to our needs. And that was very important for us to know. We didn't want to have to write some complete system from scratch, and that's why we're looking at Alias Wavefront and using its inherent ability to design your own clip effect.
We use the software not just for the particle animation, but we use it for taking apart structures and buildings. There's a shot in the movie where you see a barn being stricken by a tornado in the beginning of the film. The pieces were accomplished using particle type of animation so that we could control how the pieces come apart and react to the tornado itself, so both simulations happen in the same space.
Until digital applications, up to the moment, literally, that digital applications for filmmaking became a reality, I was thinking about getting out of the business. Railgun, it's a high-powered, essentially a rifle with a sight which allows you to see through buildings. What we were asked to create was an effect which allowed you to see the projectile. Alias Wavefront software, particularly particle systems, allowed us to manipulate the railgun effect to create this sense of ionization of the air, because it doesn't look like anything anybody's ever seen a gun do before. The X-ray effect had to be based on the reality of the scenes. And of course, during the live action pieces, you saw the actors moving through the sets. Then when you look through the viewfinder, the X-ray scope, you had to see that same set, and you had to see it essentially in infinity, because the X-ray scope could rack through this entire space. In this business, you need all the help you can get. People forget that digital image creation for motion pictures is just a few years old. Any help we get from anybody we deal with is valuable, and the help we've gotten from Alias Wavefront has been terrific.
Naughty Dog is a small development house that has a three-project deal with Universal Interactive Studios to create video game software. We started the development of Crash Bandicoot with the idea that we wanted to create a Warner Brothers cartoon character feel within a 3D game. So we brought in 2D classic cartoon animators to help us design the character. And then we animated him in Alias Wavefront to create what we hope was a squash and stretch classic Warner look. Naughty Dog decided that we wanted to push a couple of limits in Crash Bandicoot. One of them was in animation, and we felt the inverse kinematics and the clustering system that Power Animator uses was excellent, and we wanted to use Alias Wavefront to create the animation. We also wanted to create a really nice textured world. The world of Crash is very highly detailed, and Alias Wavefront allowed us to set enough textures and to manipulate a huge amount of textures within the world. We wanted to interface our proprietary tools with a software package that allowed us to do a lot of the things that we would have had to develop ourselves, and Alias Wavefront's open model allowed us to do just that. They've listened to our problems, they've solved our problems, and we're really excited to work with them in the future.
We have a philosophy on games, and that philosophy is, if it's no Scottish, it's crap. In the past, we've tried many, many graphics packages, and a couple of key things. One, we've got to recruit the best people, and the best people seem to want to work on the high-end machines, the best graphics packages, and when we say we use Alias Wavefront, that normally has a great effect on people. It offers us basically all the facilities that we need these days, and that's really important. We need great polygon animation tools, great texture mapping tools, motion capture. We have a motion capture studio. One of our games, Body Harvest, it's a game for the Nintendo 64 machine. It uses a lot of high-end 3D in that package. In that game, and we use Alias Wavefront for all the graphics in the game.
Alias Wavefront is my sketch pad. Anything that I do is done in real time. There's no slowdown in the process, and it's usable. Everything from the design stage to the finished game. And nothing comes close to Alias Wavefront.
Alias Wavefront.
Alias Wavefront.
Alias Wavefront.
Alias Wavefront.
I love science fiction, and we try to use a little bit of it in everything that we do here at Turner Production. And developing graphics for TNT, TBS, Turner Classic Movies, Cartoon Network, all of those, we have to have a very diverse set of tools to use to keep a specific identity for each network. And Alias Wavefront is, without a shadow of a doubt, the very best tool that we can use to achieve that goal. One of the things that happens here all the time is we have producers come in and they say, look, I want, most of the time before they even say, well, I wonder if you can do this, you can always almost cut them off and nod your head and say, yeah. Yeah, we can do that. We can do anything. For instance, the NFL on TNT piece that we've just finished working on, the producer wanted a big, very dynamic explosion at the end of the piece where this jumbotron screen just falls apart and blasts into the screen. It was a very complicated and very layered piece. The way that we've been able to achieve that is only with Alias Wavefront software, where it has integrated particles, its illustration, its sculpture, its lighting, its camera moves, its everything all in one package.
A lot of people think that computer animation is chrome, lights, laser beams flashing around, glints jumping off of things. We're into more organic things. We want to take things and bring characters to life and put life right in them.
This should be played at high volume.
What's the new jam?
This should be played at high volume.
Okie dokie, roll 'em!
I've been in traditional animation for about 39 years, and now I've made the switch to computer animation, and I just can't believe it. It's really fabulous. Everything that I can do, painting, sculpting, everything, they're all in there. Alias Wavefront has just been fantastic for us in that area. Among the many characters that we've been animating, we've been doing Barbie. That's been a very enjoyable bit of work doing that, working with Mattel people. And then we've done things like, oh, Arnie and Bernie, ta-da! And a little wiggler. And then we've done things like working with the Pillsbury Doughboy.
Oh boy, this is the biggest grand prize ever. So let's get started.
We might start off with a storyboard like this done by the agency, or we may do them ourselves, but then this is all in 2D and we want to do it in 3D, of course, in computer animation. So we go downstairs and work on our motion capture stage down there. I've been the Doughboy, worked down there on it. Once we've recorded everything that is the motion capture, me moving around as the Doughboy, then we can take it and it goes into the computer to be animated on. It goes into Power Animator, and then we leave him in there for maybe a couple of hours baking away, and then we bring him out, we give him a little poke in the stomach, and he's alive.
Hey, exactly!
We are not selling dreams, we are selling piece of metal, piece of a project that has to be driven by everybody, has to be driven everywhere. Italo design car are very functional. Maybe you laugh with this because there's no door, but if you don't need some function, we take it out, like this car. LS Wavefront has been a solution for us. With this new technology, we can do better and more. From the end of the 60s until today, we realize nearly 100 different cars. In the design, the process is the same, we just changed the tools, we can say. With this new technology, we can work immediately together with the engineering, so to check the feasibility, to check the quality also of the shapes. So for our designer is also good. Before going to realize the model, we really closer to the reality, and then we don't do, we really nearly eliminate some mistakes that was typical in the past. Elias Wavefront love us to be more creative. That's true. I mean, I cannot imagine a future without right now. It's a sort of a drug.
As a designer for Rollerblade, it's very important that you're close to the final product. So most of us designers, we skate. When I first joined Rollerblade, I saw a real opportunity for Alias Wavefront and Studio to be worked into the product development. The kind of product we do is very functional, yet it is very stylish and it has to look great. You know, what Alias Wavefront has allowed us to do is get into prototyping and testing very early and identifying things up front. This particular SLA part is a toe portion of the shell which slides forward and backwards. The exterior surface of the part was done in Alias Wavefront, while the interior geometry was done in Pro Engineer. There are cases where we can use Alias Wavefront all on its own. This is a very sculptural part for a youth skate, and it was designed in Studio. It was integrated with a component that was done in Pro E, and these parts mate very well. It's very controlled to bring to a product like this, which has a buckle design, easy open, easy close feature. Studio Paint has features that allow us to be more free with our designs and looser. And not only is that more fun for the individual designers, but it is a tremendous wow factor when we show it to upper management and senior management. And they get keened in and excited about the project just like we are.